Okay, Xander, TotalRock at Bloodstock with old Rake.
Hello.
Hello.
What?
I'm Rob.
I'm Rob. Yeah. I was gonna say, you are.
Rake. Band name as well.
I'm in me.
Yeah. How's it feel to have a band of your name?
Weird. People have been asking, like, what band are you in? I'm in me.
Asking.
No, people. I'm not going to
disguise.
Do you not know who I am?
Yeah.
If you walked around like that, it'd be horrible.
I mean, I actually had a disguise that could do that.
Yeah, you could put my head down.
Oh, that's
just not learned how to wear them yet.
Yeah. Is it not right?
I don't know, it isn't.
Okay. I shouldn't really have mine on. I'm not interested. So you have an album which is old Rake.
Yes.
I like what you did there.
I didn't do it.
Really?
Some fans did it and I just stole it.
So. Nice. That's good.
We've been trying to figure out who it might have been, but I have no idea.
Well, you've not even met them.
Well, it just became a thing instantly, you know, like LOL. Okay. It was just like, I was old Rake suddenly. I'd love to figure out who actually thought of that.
I like how you're comparing yourself with like the biggest terminology.
Well, it's just below LOL.
Sure. Well, who's my name? Because I'm like Jimi Hendrix. That's basically it.
Okay, well, you got to cherry pick your own musicians.
Yeah.
Is that easy, hard?
Yeah, I mean, Rob's playing live. He's in a band called Fetal Juice, which is a really good name.
Very pleasant death metal.
Yeah. And it's just, we're just mates, and we were just talking one day, like, I'm doing some live gigs. Do you want to drum? Like, yeah. And that was it.
Yeah, pretty much.
For the album, just, I was speaking to Gary Holt and James Murphy, it just kind of all happened, just emailing, and just really simply happened. It just was fluid.
I was just saying, is it just a natural flow?
Like, oh, okay, yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah, it all just happened.
Yeah,
great.
It's quite stress-free, you find,
isn't it? Writing the album was completely stressful.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it took me so long, and because I only had, like, Rob and my missus to bounce off, like, is this good?
Right.
No, it's not. Okay. Wait, it does help.
No, try again. Do it again, but better.
But it's
pushing you.
Yeah, in a way, like, it took me 6 months to even find the style. I tried like metal, death metal, and I just tried cheesy rock, and it happened. It worked.
Almost like exploring it in a cell.
Yeah, then. Yeah. Because I never, you know, there's only certain things you can do in thrash. If you try anything, you know, like major keys, it'll just be like, no, that's not metal.
Right.
So it was good to just think, I can do whatever I want.
Yeah.
So it was good.
Brilliant, on your own terms as well.
Yeah, it was great.
Sweet, okay. When are we playing then? When are we getting out?
We've just done two gigs, this and...
This is your second?
Yeah, yeah. Really? The last one was a warm-up show in Huddersfield. And, yeah, it's pretty fun.
Nice.
It's been, yeah. It's been
I didn't realise that you've played already, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah, we just played. Yeah.
Shame.
Oh, you didn't miss much.
Who else you got playing with you?
It was just me and Rob on drums, and then I just had backing tracks of the bass and rhythm because it's just simpler that way. And we had, I can't say who it is because it's funnier.
Oh, yeah.
But two guys in morph suits miming on garden rakes.
Really?
And
oh, rakes?
Yeah. Just miming the backing tracks. Because it was better than if it was just me and Rob, just like. Yeah. It'd just be awkward.
We've only ever had them for the gigs. We've not, like, met them for a practice or anything. So the Huddersfield game...
You need to practice playing a rake.
Yeah, but we needed to...
They had a rehearsal on mic stands. They were like...
Well, I guess I need to know...
But we needed to practice how not to laugh at them whilst playing a rake.
It's so hard to play.
On the first gig.
Maybe it could be something you could feature in a track one day, just some grating rakes.
Make an octave of rake,
or like
bronze.
Some drums. Yeah. No, like brushes on sticks, rakes on drums. Yeah.
Just, I'm going to steal that.
Yeah, we were going to make all the cymbal stands into rakes and try and have two big rakes as drumsticks. It's like, no, it's overkill, this, isn't it?
Before I got Rob on drums, I was going to make a rake kit with all these rakes and get a cardboard cut out of like Lionel Richie and just stand it there as if he's drumming. But then I thought about it more and that was just ridiculous.
So are you going to fill those positions at all?
I don't think so, no. I don't want to get back into the band situation. And you know, it's just me and Rob having a laugh, and you know,
that's good.
That's about it.
But it's less to equipment to carry, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just easier.
Yeah, exactly.
Drums and one amp.
Just one car, drive somewhere, drive back, have a few beers, done.
I've got this Kemper amplifier that's the best thing I've ever had. You just turn up, plug in, and it sounds amazing. It's so stress-free. Today I just plugged in, played. Oh,
that's nice.
And I was set up, that was it.
Great. Yeah. Cool, okay. What bands are you going to watch tonight?
Hopefully Cannibal Corpse on there, if we can get to see him in time. Rob Zombie.
Onslaught.
Onslaught as well, yeah.
And Black... Did you say Black Label?
Yeah, Black Label.
Yeah, I want to see a few Step Aside, Childs and Squeals. Zach. Step Aside, Childs. And then we.
Well, on that note, I'll let you go. Enjoy yourselves.
Thank you very much, sir.
Hi, there's Cheers.